Tell me, how do you beat Mario games? Well, by completing levels and saving the princess. How do you do that? By running, jumping, moving right, and also moving left. But what if all of a sudden, for no reason at all, we couldn't actually go left anymore? Would it be possible to beat Super Mario 3D World? This is what we'll find out today. The rules are simple. We are going to try to beat Super Mario 3D World on the Wii U without ever pressing the left button on the gamepad. How do we do that? Well, I tried many ways to alter my Wii U gamepad with various tools to, you know, remove the left option, but my best bet remains the good old electric tape. Oh, tape, you never let me down. Basically, we'll be playing all of the levels, but without ever pressing the left D-pad button or moving the control stick left, and hopefully, we'll eventually get to the final fight and maybe even beat it. Now that everything has been set, let's do this. World 1-1 is where you'll get familiar with the controls for this challenge. Thankfully, this game is 3D-ish, so when you hit a block, you can move up and down to grab the power-up that's inside, so this is pretty helpful. Moving the camera is also going to be very efficient for this quest, but sadly, we cannot move it in all 360 directions. We'll have to do with what the game gives us. To make it far in Super Mario 3D World, you absolutely have to collect those green stars, as they're often mandatory to open up new levels. So we'll have to get as many as we can through the quest, which is simpler said than done. For example, catching this bunny without moving left can be quite troublesome and will require a bit of luck. 1-2 takes place underground and the level in itself is mostly linear, wanting you to go from left to right, so this one is super easy to beat. And since this quest might get difficult, make sure to get a lot of 1-up by using this one simple trick with the Koopa down there. If you didn't know about this trick yet, well, it's because you're not following me on TikTok, where I post daily gaming tricks, so you should do that right now. Shameless promotion aside, 1-A is a basic fight against two charging Chucks, and your best bet here will be to stay in the center of the arena and wait for them to come and attack you, so it will be very simple. 1-3 is a vertical level where you have to climb up this big mountain, and without the ability to go left, this is going to be troublesome. If you make your way up by going right there, well, you cannot actually go back left and are forced to jump to your death, which isn't really cool. Is this the end for this quest already? Nope, not at all, as it's time for me to introduce you to the cat suit and all it allows you to do. If you jump and attack, you can do a cat dive, which can move you left without you actually pressing left, if you're facing that direction, of course. And one of the best ways to face left is by using a tree or by doing a wall jump on a right wall. The cat suit also allows you to climb on walls, so using all of those new moves, you will be able to climb to the top of the mountain without ever pushing left. Nice! 1-4 is a very difficult stage where you have to use Plessy to ride down the lake, and without the ability to move left, this part here is a bit troublesome. The only way to move left here is to bump on those enemies, but even while doing that, I couldn't get in the secret waterfall passage over there. I managed to get very close to it sometimes, but I never actually got it to work. Thankfully, this stage being on a split path, we can already move on to 1-5, so it's no problem. 1-5 wants you to push all of those blue switches, and without the ability to move left, this is a bit tricky. Thankfully, there are some walls pretty much everywhere, so you can always do a wall jump followed by a couple cat dives to move left. I also learned later down the line that you can just use the touchscreen on the Wii U gamepad to push down those switches, but I learned that like a million levels later, so meh. Before going to 1-Castle, let's take a minute to talk about the multiple Captain Toad levels in the game. These levels give you full 360 controls of the camera, and that's kind of the gimmick behind those stages. Obviously, by being able to move the camera in all directions, well, you're never forced to push left. It will lead to some very awkward camera angles where you can barely see Captain Toad or where you're actually supposed to go, but it's obviously possible. And that goes for every single Captain Toad levels in the game, so I won't mention them again. 1-Castle is a pretty easy stage, as the camera can be moved left and right, leading to us being able to move left if we move it around correctly. We'll soon reach Bowser and get to fight him. And this fight could have been tough, yeah, if we'd have lost control of the camera, but thankfully, the game gives us full control of it again, so it is easy to move left or right to dodge the lava puddles and other hazards thrown by Bowser. And with Bowser gone, we can move on to World 2. 2-1 features a lot of conch door enemies, but they're not very difficult to defeat or avoid, and this level is pretty simple. After getting the final green star over there, you might think you're stuck on the right side of the screen forever, without any way to go back left, but it is finally time for me to introduce you to the infamous
zigzag camera technique of epicness.
Basically, this is Mario, and if you move up or down, this is where he goes. But then, if you move the camera to the right, then all of a sudden, if you press up, Mario goes that way. Then, if you move it to the left and press down, Mario goes that way. Taking a look at this, we can see we moved Mario left. And if we keep doing that, we'll see that we can actually move Mario left without ever pressing left super easily. 2-2 features those blocks that can be moved by using the touchscreen and those platforms that move when we blow into the Wii U gamepad. Going left is almost never needed, so don't worry about this stage. 2-3 is a very easy level, and it could almost pass as a 2D level from a game like New Super Mario Bros. U. Simply move to the end and grab a couple green stars while you're at it, and you'll be good. 2-4 is home to those rolling hills, so if you ever need to move left, just stand on a hill that moves left, and it will bring you right where you need to be. Easy. 2-A is a super easy fight against three big Galoombas. Move the camera and keep using the zigzag technique and you won't have any problems. 2-Mystery House is home to 5 enemies to defeat if you want to get 5 green stars, and for most of those enemies, you can just chill in the center of the arena and wait for them to attack you. When you actually need to move left, just use the wall to face the left side and do a couple of cat dive attacks. 2-5 was just very easy, and there's not much to say about it. And it's kind of the same for 2-Tank, which is an auto-scrolling stage where you always need to move right, so there is no need for any left presses in here. Boom Boom the Mad Lad is not very difficult, as he always spins in your direction, so just time your jumps and you'll be good. World 3 is upon us, and I think it's fitting for me to talk about the world map here, and how I actually move through it. As you can see, the first level is located to the left, so you'd assume I have to push left to get to the level. Well, we actually are able to move the camera left and right in pretty much every corner of the world map. So once again, the zigzag technique is all we need to move left, so no need for any left presses here. 3-1 features some ice, so watch out if you do a cat dive because you can't push left to stop sliding once you start doing it, and this could prove to be problematic down the line. 3-2 is an auto-scroller stage where you need to climb on many moving fences, and although the first part is pretty easy to beat, as soon as you enter that box there, you will face a new challenge. A part where you need to move left and cannot move the camera around. No more zigzag technique, and even with a cat suit, there's not much you can do. This level is actually not possible to beat, but lucky for us, this stage is also located on a split path, so we can try to beat 3-3 instead. And good news, 3-3 is actually a very easy ghost house stage and never actually requires us to go left. When it does, to get a green star for example, well, we can just move the camera around and move left that way, so no biggie. 3-4 is also a very easy stage, as we can see the flagpole from the very start. Move the camera left and right to make your way to the end, and you'll be good. 3-A, the Magikoopa blockade, is pretty easy, as you can just wait for Magikoopa to teleport to a convenient spot that's on your right. Easy peasy. 3-5 takes place underwater. Yay, finally one of those stages. Do not worry, as this stage is pretty easy to complete, even without using the left button. There are plenty of ways to move left, like those clear pipes over there, or the good old camera zigzag trick. 3-6 forces you to run super fast to the right, as it's a Mario Kart inspired level, so it's pretty easy. 3-7 is filled with those arrow platform lifts that only move when you're on the arrow. Not being able to move left can be quite annoying, but most of the time you have control of the camera, so you can get on the correct arrow anyways. 3-Train is really similar to 2-Tank, because it also is an auto-scroller stage where all you must do is move right and wait for the screen scroll to catch up. Fighting Pom-Pom is a bit annoying if you forgot a cat suit, as you'll have to rely on luck so that the real Pom-Pom appears on your right. If that's not the case, well, just avoid the shurikens and wait and you'll be okay. Redash B is a fight against Histocrat, and this boss is actually super easy to beat. Just move up and down and use your cat suit to climb on those snakes and reach the boss's head. It's that easy. No need for any camera trick. 4-1 will require you to have a cat suit to be able to climb this vertical section near the start, as you'll need to use lots of cat dive attacks to move left. The rest of the level is pretty easy though. 4-2 is full of poison water everywhere, so you'd want to move the camera around to avoid falling down in it and losing a life. After getting out of that green pipe, climb up this wall there and make your way to the red pipe to skip right to World 5. To clear World 5-1, we need to collect 5 tokens, and 4 of them are not that difficult to get if you're being smart and collecting them from left to right, but this one on the clouds there is a pain in the butt. You have to use this clear pipe to move up on the cloud, and because you're close to that little dude with binoculars, you lose control of the camera, so using the zigzag technique is not possible. You can, however, tilt the gamepad around and do little steps, and you'll eventually get close enough to get the token without actually touching it, thanks to its big hitbox. The second part involves Plessy, but thankfully, we don't have to actually move left to beat it, so we're good. World 5-2 worried me because it's full of those circus trapeze things, and usually you tilt the joystick left and right to swing and get far enough, but it turns out you can just go right and wait for the trapeze to move back left and then repeat to get enough momentum to make it past the endless pits. 5-A is another fight against some charging chucks, so it's gonna be super easy. We can't really do 5-3 now because of the lack of green stars, so let's go to the next one. 5-4 is very easy, as it's a very big world, so there's not much that will stop you. 5-5 takes place underground and is very linear, so going right is all you need to do to get to the end. 5-6 has those platforms that spin when you jump, and without the ability to move left, do not mess up your jumps. Just plan your moves and you'll be good. 5-7 is a very difficult stage. You have to move up this fortress, and this requires you to go left many times. That means we'll have to use the camera zigzag technique, but as soon as you get caught by one of those searchlights, some evil bullet bills get sent your way, and if they destroy the blocks in your path, you're in big trouble. The final part where you need to make your way to the top is even more difficult, as you absolutely need to have a Tanuki suit if you want to stand a chance. You have to move left by tilting the camera and pushing up on the D-pad, but with all of the bullet bills attacking you, this took me quite a while and a couple of tries. It looks awkward, it plays awkward, but it is actually possible. 5-Castle is way easier than the level we just beat, so reaching the boss will take no time at all. Defeating it is not a big deal either, although I have to admit that not pushing left and instead moving the camera around was confusing to me and I had trouble not getting hit at least once. World 6-1 contains lots of clear pipes and involves lots of climbing, but we have control of the camera, so it's no biggie. 6-2 is really easy, although pushing the bullies down is harder when you're not being able to move left. With 6-3 locked, let's go to 6-4, which is a pretty simple level where you just ride this raft until the end. Considering you can move the camera in all directions, this one will be done in no time. 6-A is a boss fight with Prince Bully, and considering you can use the clear pipes to move left, the whole arena is available for you, so it's pretty easy. 6-5 is an easy snow-themed stage, and there's not much to say about it. 6-6 involves a lot of climbing up, but it features lots of cloud platforms and you'll soon get a cat suit, so this stage is not really difficult, and there's plenty of ways to move left if needed. 6-7 was one of those stages that scared me when I was planning this challenge, as it takes place in a tower where evil fuzzies are coming at you, and you have to climb very fast, going left and right. You cannot move the camera around in this stage, so the good old zigzag technique won't be of any help. But if you have a cat suit, you can actually use the walls to face the left side and do some cat dives to move left. And we have enough time to clear the stage without dying from the fuzzies, so this one is possible. 6-Tank is an easy stage, you know, kinda like all of the previous tank and train stages. We cannot move the camera, sure, but since the camera in the stage is diagonal, we can easily move left and right without actually pressing left or right. Defeating Boom Boom is super easy once again. Stay near the center, and that's it. 6-C is a boss fight against Boss Blob. And to be fair, I actually beat this dude on my first try by just moving up and down. Yeah, just avoid his jumps and ground pound attacks, and then attack him with your cat suit, and he's gonna be gone in no time. What a joke. 7-1 is full of clear pipes and blue lava everywhere, so you'll have to be extra careful. Thankfully, it's not gonna be that difficult. 7-2 is a top-down level. You know, kinda like the Legend of Zelda games. It's super cool, except sometimes you have to go left, so this means you'll have to awkwardly hug the wall by pressing up to slowly move that way. It looks so funny. There's a couple more switches to press, but once more, just start from the left side, making your way onto the right side when possible, and you'll be good. And if everything else fails, use the touchscreen. 7-3 is a level full of boost panels, so you'll have to run at all times. And this level is difficult enough without restricting your ability to go left. I sadly wasn't able to clear this part using my dude Mario. The gap is just too big. Thankfully, Super Mario 3D World contains 4 different characters to choose from, and Princess Peach is going to be the one we need, because she can glide in the air for a couple seconds. Clearing that gap is now super easy, and this level will be done. 7-4 is kinda tricky, because you have to make your moves super fast on those arrow platforms that disappear. This part here requires you to use the zigzag technique really fast, but don't panic, use your muscle memory, and you'll be good. To defeat this boss in 7-A, you'll have to keep moving around him, so this means lots of camera spinning. It is very stressful, and not gonna lie, very difficult, but it is possible. 7-B is a way easier boss though, as it's Prince Bully once again. Just use the clear pipes to move left when needed, and kick his face 3 times to win. 7-5 is a very complicated level to navigate. It takes place inside of those glass boxes, and inside of those, you cannot move the camera around. So you'll have to walk up and down and hug those walls if you want to move to the next part. This second box is especially problematic, because once you grab the 5th key token, evil purple gas appears from the top and start descending on you. And sadly, I tried a lot, but we cannot be fast enough to slide down to safety no matter what we do. I tried to use Peach and her gliding ability, I tried using Mario, I tried using Toad that goes faster, but no, it's no use. This level is not possible. But, once again, it is on a split path! Dude, we're so lucky! 7-6 is way easier, taking place underwater, only featuring a couple of enemies to dodge, but nothing that will be a problem. Oof, we're good to go. 7-7 features lava that rises from time to time, so just make sure you're on a green platform when it does, and you'll be good. So, at this point, I realized I didn't have enough green stars to keep playing the next levels, so I ended up going back to previous stages to get green stars I missed, and also decided to complete World 4 as well. I mean, I need a lot of green stars. And without going into too much detail, just know that all of the levels in that world are possible. Now, with enough stars in hand, let's go to World 7-Castle. This stage starts off with a very precise diagonal jump we have to make above the lava. As you can see, it is really precise and very stressful, but it is possible. What is left of this stage and the Bowser fight are super easy to do, as you can move the camera around without a problem. World 8-1 contains a whole lot of spikes to avoid, and that's very scary, especially near the end where you have to time your jumps and make a diagonal jump as well. 8-2 is a Plessy stage, and as you can see, it's not very promising without going left. Ugh. Those Plessy stages are always a problem in this quest. At this point, you know, I'm gonna have to say it. Plessy is not a hero. 8-3 contains one annoying part where you need to climb up these delicious looking cookies. Yummy. We have to do more diagonal jumps to make it without a cat suit, and it's really confusing, but it is possible. 8-Train is super easy, so don't worry about it. The Pom Pom fight is just like the previous one, so it is also very easy. 8-4 is where you'll need to be using the zigzag technique a lot, But since I had practiced this technique for hours at this point, it wasn't that much of a problem to me. 8-5 is not very difficult, as you just have to take your time as you swim in those floating blobs of water. But then, oh gosh, it's Plessy again. Oh, no worries this time around, as there's no need to go left at all. Okay, Plessy, you know what? I'm sorry. Plessy is a hero. 8-6 is really easy. Just grab a flashlight, defeat some evil ghosts, and make your way to the end. 8-Bucks involves lots of climbing to do as Cat Mario, but most of the time you can move the camera around to make it to the green star in time. I managed to get the first 9 stars, but I just couldn't be fast enough to grab the 10th one. It might be possible, but I'm too slow. 8-7 is super difficult. You have to walk on those moving boxes, and normally you'd be able to walk left as the blocks are moving right, but we can't do this anymore in this quest, so now we have to jump and go right instead, which is very precise and complicated, and if you mess up, well, in the lava you go. This level will be scary, and you will die a lot, but keep persevering and you will eventually reach the flagpole. 8-A and 8-B are just a revenge fight against Histocrat and Boss Blob. No need to panic, because as you saw earlier in the video, these fights are pretty easy. It's now time to go to World 8-Castle, the final stop of the day, and the level in itself is pretty easy. There's not a lot of going left involved. Just make sure to grab a cat suit and have a second one in your backup items, as the fight against Meowser is way more difficult. Basically, it is an auto-scrolling stage where you have to dodge the many attacks of Meowser. We cannot move the camera at all during this fight, meaning we'll have to hope for the best if we don't want to be stuck. For this first part there, just grab onto the corner and keep making your way up, using clear pipes when possible. Just keep hugging the wall by pressing up or down, and eventually you will get to the power block and will be able to beat the first part. Now, this second part is way more complicated, as you'll need to be moving left before getting to the top, and to do so, hop in the middle section there and grab onto that trapeze. Jump when you're on the left side and hop on that moving cloud over there. You'll have to do all of this very fast, and often out of screen, because if you wait for too long, well, Meowser is going to appear and ruin your day. When you manage to get on top there, you have to walk up this staircase, and as you can see, if we go up this first floor, well, there's no way to go left anymore, and we cannot even climb the wall. I can't believe we're gonna have to push left that close to the end. Aw, this is so sad. Except it's not, because we don't have to press left. Remember how I told you wanted to be on the left side at all costs going up there? Well, that's because you'll want to climb on the right side of this tower to do a cat dive attack to go back on the staircase and then move up there by climbing the wall. Now, just move right with the spinning camera up until you reach the very top. And now we finally have control of the camera, so let's move it and adjust ourselves to be able to go under the power block, and there we go! Meowser is defeated! Yes! We saved the world again! That's so cool! So, is it possible to beat Super Mario 3D World without pressing left? Yes, it is! Oh my gosh, I cannot believe this challenge was possible. It wasn't easy though. I often died and some of those levels were really painful and it took me a long time. And even the final boss was one heck of a challenge. But yes, it is possible and I did it. Now, this deserves a thumbs up and a share, my dudes, cause that was a tough one. Thanks a lot for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed it. If this was your first time watching me, well, why don't you subscribe and hit the bell to know when I post my next challenge videos. And I have plenty more for you to watch, so tap the cards on screen right now to watch more epic gamer challenges like these, and follow me on many social medias. If you want gaming tricks, follow me on TikTok. If you want funny memes, follow me on Twitter. And if you're old, follow me on Facebook. I don't know. Anyways, I will see you in the next one.